Hi and welcome to Mars Makes. Today I'm showing how to make birds out of rose petals and some ideas of how you can use them. To start, I'm plucking the petals off the roses carefully and one by one so that they don't break. Smaller petals are needed for the head and younger roses give smaller petals, but sometimes the inner petals of larger roses can be quite small. These are the petals I'm using to create my bird. Here I'm cutting the double-sided sticky tape in two strips. First, I'm making the bottom of the body using three large petals. The easiest way to peel off the tape is by peeling one end off with your nail and then keeping it between your finger and thumb. Before using each petal, I'm turning it inside out, being careful to not bend the petal because otherwise it turns brown. I'm applying tape to the base of the petal in a V shape close to the edge, attaching the tape to the three corners of the V and then gently patting the tape down along the lines of the V. This is to minimize how much I'm touching the tape, as when you try to remove your finger from it, layers of the petal can peel off. I'm layering two petals and gently pressing to stick them together. Then I'm putting tape in a V shape on the reverse side of the third petal and joining it onto the other petals in the opposite direction. For the top of the body, I'm layering two petals in the same direction. Next, I'm making the tail and following the same method of layering 5 to 6 petals and sticking them together. For the wings, I'm layering 3 petals on each wing. Then I'm taking 4 strips of double-sided sticky tape and sticking them to the outer sides of the base of the body, close to the edge of the petals. Then I'm sticking the top of the body on top of the wings like so. I've taken a piece of tissue and I'm folding it into a long pointy shape and holding it together with sticky tape, making sure the sticky tape is smoothly applied as any sticking out edges can damage the petal. Next, I'm cutting off the back end of the tissue shape so that the back isn't sharp, again so that the petal doesn't damage. Then, after placing the tissue onto the top of the bird, I'm sticking on the base of the body by overlapping the sides of the base onto the top and gently pressing down. I'm sticking down tape in a V shape on the top of the front of the body and gently folding it upwards to make the front smoother, making sure that the petals don't bend. This petal is for the head and I'm turning it inside out and placing tape in a V shape at the base of the petal on the reverse side. I'm also turning the end of the petal upwards to make the head more 3D. Next, I'm gently pressing the head onto the front of the body. I'm applying the tape to the sides of the inside of the wings. Because my petals are wider, I'm also gently folding along the middle to make the wing narrower. And then I'm sticking the sides of the wing onto the body. So that's the finished bird. You can use it as decoration on its own or attach them to wire by placing wire inside the tissue and putting more tape to strengthen the joint between the tissue and wire. Then I put the tissue into the bird like before and bent the wire, laying the bird's tail over it. I've put them into a bouquet by wrapping the wire around the stem of the rose. Some rose petals have yellow bases which look like beaks, as you can see on this bird. You can also dry the birds. Here's the transition, and they start to shrivel too much at around 5 days. dried white petals don't look good, but I think that coloured petals work well. You can store the fresh birds for 3 to 4 days by placing them in a sealed box with a damp kitchen towel and putting this in the fridge. Thanks for watching! Don't forget to subscribe, like and share if you like the video, and I'll see you next time. Bye!